I grew up getting off the school bus and going to work in my grandmother's garden. And that entailed going and pulling weeds. That entailed going around and looking at a lot of her plants in her garden. And, you know, it's one of those things where it was a work and a chore at first, but then I began to love all the Japanese maples she had planted around her garden. She started planting Japanese maples in the 1950s. I mean, that's just something that just is a thing of beauty. And as a kid getting to experience that with my grandmother, it's something that I'll never forget. And then it started being a thing where on the weekends we would go help Dad at local tailgate markets. We'd help him go to different tailgate markets and sell Japanese maples. We'd load up our Buick or my old Jeep and stuff as many Japanese maples as could fit in there. And then we'd take them to the local tailgate market and just sit around and wait for people to walk up. And it's one of those things where we love it and we are so passionate about it. And a lot of this deals with, you know, our roots, where we've got our grandmother who grows Japanese maples and we got a love from her. And then my dad on the other side of the family who started growing Japanese maples. And he would just go to flea markets and just sell as many Japanese maples as he could. And Matt and I would be sitting over on the side selling plants so that we could collect things. And now the things we collect are Japanese maples. I mean, we're still doing the same thing we were doing when I was 5. Going out there, selling plants to collect more plants. So it's a passion that we love. And it's an honor that so many of y'all have begin to love what we love as well. And we really appreciate y'all.
I would say it was in 2008 when Tim and I got kind of more serious about the nursery. We took what Dad was doing as a hobby. He was locally selling around the Hendersonville area at different tailgate markets. And we continued to expand from there. It was around 2011 that we got more serious about mail order. And we decided that would be the new direction for our business as we focused on mail order. And we've continued to expand from there and we've been very blessed.
In the last years, our business at Mr. Maple has grown drastically. Our family here, our staff, we went from having 3 or 4 employees to now we have over 30 employees here at Mr. Maple. It just blows my mind, and everybody is so amazing. I mean, these are the people that work hard each and every day to get out orders for you. These are the people that are editing our videos. These are the people that are shooting the videos. These are the people that are going out there and finding those limited release items. Our staff is top notch, and we've been so blessed just to have so many amazing people here at Mr. Maple.
One of the most fun things is getting to do this in a family setting. We don't take it lightly here at our business. Even our employees, it's kind of like a family setup. So we enjoy those relationships. And I love getting to do this with my brother. I mean, it's something that I don't think I would have the same zest for this if I didn't get to do it with my little brother.
Matt and I, we've always been a team. And to have grown our nursery together and working with my brother, it's something that, you know, not many people say they could work together with their brothers or their family, but my brother and I, we just work so well together, and it's something I enjoy. I mean, Matt's passion about Japanese maples, my passion about Japanese maples, we fuel each other more, and we get to talk about and do things that other people would never really think about, and I think that's one of the reasons why we stay sort of on the cutting edge of Japanese maples, is because I've got my brother, and he's agging me on, and I'm agging him on. And so we get extra tree geeky about it, more than most people would let themselves get, because we've got two people here who are just as passionate about it. And that's what I love about working with my brother.
So I have people say to me, you love what you do, you're passionate about it. You know, there's that old adage, if you love what you do, you never work a day in your life. And I always say, that's kind of true, maybe, but not really. So if you love what you do, you work harder to make sure you don't lose that thing, whether it's your faith, whether it's your marriage, whether it's relationships, you work harder at that thing. And that's something we're always trying to do here, is put in a little bit more at Mr. Maple. One, to keep you guys coming back. We want to give you, you know, talk shows about Japanese maples, YouTube videos. We want to share this passion and get people more enthralled with it. And our goal is always to expand things for Japanese maples. You know, we're humble here, we really are, but we try to look at the bigger picture of what maples are and how can we keep that growing and expanding. And we're always looking at what's next for Japanese maples and how do we get there.
one of the things that we've really been blessed about is having two parents that support us 1,000% with Mr. Maple. Our mom, she's been one of our biggest cheerleaders. She's always been on Facebook and social media sharing and saying, hey, check out my boys. But then we've got a dad too that has shared his passion of growing Japanese maples with us. And he's really always been there for us when we needed help. Hey dad, we need help building a greenhouse. And he'd come out and really help us understand exactly how to build the greenhouse. And having two parents that really helped us grow our business has been something that, you know, we just can't say enough great things about.
Hello, I'm Matt and Tim's dad. And I started growing Japanese maples back in the 70s. And I used to grow them in my backyard as a hobby. And people like Japanese maples, so I started selling them, people to work with, and taking them to garden centers or garden shows and selling them, or tailgates. And my hobby turned into Mr. Maple. And I'm really proud of what Matt and Tim's done with it.
The first time Tim and I visited Buchholz Nursery was in 09. It was the Maple Society meeting, and Tim and I couldn't be more excited to visit this magical place. I know before we left for then, we had a yard sale, and we sold basically everything we owned to be able to afford some plane tickets to go out to Oregon to see what all this was about and to kind of expand what we were doing. And one of the biggest parts of that trip was getting to go and see Buchholz Nursery, and it was a magical land. It didn't disappoint. It was like going into Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. It was something I'll never forget that first time we got there, and it was worth selling everything we owned to make it happen.
We not only sold everything that we owned, we cashed in on all of our future birthday presents and Christmas presents, and all of our aunts and uncles gave us money just to go to this Oregon trip. And one of the things I remember is when we went and visited Buchholz Nursery, they had a poster of Buchholz Nursery. And I mean, walking around the nursery and everything was just amazing. I mean, I saw a rainbow for the first time and my heart started pumping. And I was like, man, this place is amazing. It's a dream. And then later on that night, Talon was actually at the same hotel in Tigard, Oregon that we were at. And Matt and I played rock, paper, scissors to go see who would go up to the door and knock and ask for his autograph. And I ended up losing, ended up going to the door and getting Talon to autograph. And he said, best of luck, Talon Buchholz, on the poster. And that's just something that I'll always remember. I mean, we've looked up to Talon for years, and Talon has been a mentor to us.
We try to keep that passion going always here. And one of the fun things about it is we're always thinking big. I think it's time to spark that interest up. It's time to get excited again. And it's time for the next phase here at our nursery.
Like I was saying, I'm very proud of my two sons, Matt and Tim, the way they've handled Mr. Maple. And now I would like to say I'm especially proud that they're buying Buchholz Nursery.
Hey y'all, it's September 29th, and if you've, you know, put all the tea leaves together, Tim and I have been out here in Oregon. Today we officially sign on as the new owners of Buchholz Nursery.
Man, I truly feel blessed. We're just about to go to the lawyer's office and sign. I mean, we couldn't do this without y'all. We really appreciate y'all.
Guys, this place means a lot to us. It means a lot to Maples. You know, it means a lot to Talon. I know he's thinking about it a lot today. And we're just excited to continue on the legacy that Talon Buchholz has started here at Buchholz Nursery. All right, guys, well, it's September 29th. We just finished doing some paperwork to sign on as owners of Buchholz Nursery.
And I'm very happy about that, and the energy that they're going to bring to Buchholz Nursery is most welcome, and they made the process easy, and I've been in business for 43 years and have enjoyed most of it, but I knew it was time to retire, and I wasn't sure what was going to happen with the place. At one point, it even seemed like it would all be liquidated. We're standing in front of probably the largest Makawa Yatsubusa maple in the world, and I feared for its future. And now, thankfully, I think it's safe and gonna be well cared for. So I appreciate Tim and Matt for their support over the years. I've watched them grow into a very successful company, and I know you're all happy with their product, and they're gonna take over Buchholz Nursery and regrow it again. I told my wife, this is the second happiest day of my life.
That's a good compliment.
And then she quickly said, after our marriage, right? And yes, dear, after our marriage. So I'm just glad to be on this recording, and it's one of the best days of my life.
Oh man, we're so excited. The best is yet to come. And I think it's going to be a perfect partnership here. The two businesses are going to be amazing together. I think it's going to work really well hand in hand. And I think we're going to be able to benefit what you do here and vice versa a lot. So,
guys, I feel just blessed. Talon made this process as easy as possible on us. And it's one of those things where it seemed like everything just like it was meant to be. I mean, this whole process seems like it was meant to be, that God's hand was planning this. And it's just an honor and a privilege now to be taking over Buchholz Nursery.